Today we're looking at wide rocker switches from Hamilton.
I'll try not to make you cry during this one, Gordon.
Is that your installation work? Well, we'll see in a while what's behind that. Wide rocker switches, well, Gary, apparently this is on trend now. So Hamilton have decided to roll it across their decorative range, but already incredibly popular in hotel projects and different parts of the world. There is a preference for a wide rocker.
Right, okay. Grab the one on the end then. So let's take a look, because I've been playing around with these and these are really tactile. I really like them.
Yeah, okay. Very easy to operate and yet a good positive switch action on there. Nice.
Yeah, it is. Turn it over. Yeah, okay, so obviously that's the bit the electrician's really interested in. And obviously I've been away and I've been connecting these up and there's some great features also on the back here. So I'll not really show you the full install, but I'll show you the key points. The termination holes are huge. I've got three doubled over cables here, so feed in, feed out, and the feed up to the lighting point itself. And when I back it off, Gordon, the screw, it gets stiff at the point that I'm fully opened.
Yeah, right, yeah, so you're not going to risk that screw dropping out onto the floor.
No, and they've identified for me, it's a two-way switch being used as a one-way. They've actually identified the terminal in the switch that is for the one-way as well, so there's no guessing for the electrician.
Yeah, that's a good handy feature.
Yeah, it is. So tighten this back in. You know, we've talked there and they've gone in, no problem, haven't they? Did you see me struggling for those three doubled over cables? Not at all. Trim itself, you could leave it on if you want, but if you happen to take it off, as I did here, it says top.
So oh, right, that's
exactly
good.
How to get it on, yeah.
Yeah, so just that trim is useful when you obviously when you've got damp plaster surface or recently wallpapered or something like that. It obviously prevents some corrosion problems over the longer term.
Okay, so we wind back our screws, because obviously we're going to have a screwless front to this, and there is something very satisfying about clipping into place, once you've levelled up your box, clipping into place the front antique brass, in this case, plate.
Yeah, there's something about the Hamilton plates are very easy to clip on and remove, which is something we have struggled with on other ones in the past. You end up nearly wrenching the switch off the wall to get the decorative plate off.
Okay, and there it is. I've just clipped that back into position. Lovely. So this one I've left the trim plate on, so you can see it there, I left it on. Again, it says top again, so you can get it around the right way. It says actually top on the switch as well as the back plate. Screwing it back into position again and levelling it up. And again, that satisfying feeling of inserting.
Just got your fingerprints to wipe off there now, Gary. Well, Gary, made that look easy.
Yeah, believe it or not, I am an electrician, Gordon. Okay, and I like features that make electricians' life easier. And if you look at that one gang two-way switch, clearly identified the one-way element as well as it did on the two gang and the three gang switches, making it so much easier when you've got it on the wall that you aren't going to go back after testing to rotate it round or move a conductor over. I like that.
Sounds like you've made a few mistakes in the past with that, Gary.
Yeah, that's from personal experience, I would suggest there, yeah.
Yeah, so obviously, yeah, from an electrician's point of view, fantastic. Now, when it comes to finishers, that's normally a customer choice, and they probably may not pay much attention to actually how easy it is for you to install them, but there is a fantastic range of finishers, and well, let's just have a little closer look at some of the ones we've got here. So let's have a look at some of the Hamilton range that we've got here. Start with our favourite finish, it's very on trend at the minute, it's the antique brass, which again is a single rocker and a black plastic trim around that rocker switch. Next up, we've got a satin brass front, three individual rockers and a white plastic trim, but there's also an accessory for that to give you that rope edge finish. We'll come back to that in a while. And next up, we've got a polished brass, again, black insert around there for the plastic and dual gang switching option. And some other popular finishes, we've got a bright chrome dual gang one here with obviously the wide rocker and a quartz grey insert around there. And rounding off with our satin steel, again, single gang with a white insert around the rocker as well. So we've just shown you just a small selection of the range of finishers available from Hamilton. Check out the video we made on the Heartland range. Joe goes into more details, up to more finishers, and obviously products that complement the rocker switches, the sockets, and some of the other control elements in there. But on trend, Gary, you got excited when you saw this, a rope edge.
Yeah, it takes me back to 1980, and I'd say to you, Gordon, relax, don't do it. However, this could be coming up in places like public houses, you know, that quaint little village pub. It's got the Toby jugs on the shelf, it's got brass horseshoes, and that's where it's going to sit, I would suggest, that this type of accessory would sit here. However, it's more popular elsewhere in the world.
Yeah, still, so again, yeah, we have our current current on-trend finishes, obviously different parts of the world, and Hamilton service these projects worldwide, particularly in things like hotels, then possibly the rope edge brass lives on in some modern day installations.
But just to say, it won't make a massive revival in 2021, I would suggest.
Yeah, so one good little feature, obviously, I showed getting the place plates on and off is incredibly easy with the Hamilton range. There is one little detail to look at. Yeah, tiny little insert there to get your screwdriver in when you need to remove the plate. So just, yeah, that's a key bit to remember. And again, that plastic trim to help with the installation as well.
Right, okay, so that's taking it through there. We've looked at the finishes. Now, when I picked them up, I've got obviously another reason why a switch mechanism that's larger and easier to operate is such a benefit to me now personally. So in the last 12 months, unfortunately, and you're fully aware of this, my daughter had a tragic accident that meant her predominant arm was taken away from about the middle of here, away from her. So having a switch that's easy to operate maybe with a different part of the body, maybe an elbow or maybe the end of her arm, is obviously a massive benefit to us. Now, I'm sure that wasn't necessarily the first design feature that I thought, but it was the first thing when I picked it up. I thought, wow, what a lovely, easy mechanism, and how large the switches were to make it easier for my daughter. However, I'm sure somebody's going to say, why can't she use her other hand? I totally agree with that, and she would more often than not. She walks into a room, she opens the door, she's only got one hand, she's got a cup of tea, a can of Coke, etc. The likelihood she'll be using an elbow or part of her arm in order to operate the switches. So I thought that was wonderful. Look at that switch, that's perfect for the scenario that my daughter's going to find as she moves through her life.
Yeah, and it's, you know, none of us are all getting any younger. And obviously, yeah, people talk about Part M and accessible buildings and things like that. And obviously, you know, we're not going to get into that there because that's an extensive document. But whatever you can do to make people's lives easier, you know, especially, yeah, as Gary gets older, he's going to need those wide rocker switches as well.
But with high-end design, I would suggest. These are beautiful switches and the range is massive, isn't it? I doubt there's anything out there that they're already produced in the Hamilton range. But as always, we're interested in your feedback. Have you been fitting these switches by Hamilton? Is there a hidden gem and you would like to add it into the actual comments itself? If there is, please leave those. If someone's in the comments asking about the range and you know the answer, could you help them out? You know, it will save us a few comments as well, which we really like. As always, we're interested in all of those comments. We'd like you to leave them below and we'll try and get back to as many as we can.